The wait for the West Nile subregion to be connected to the national electricity grid will continue for another 3 months.
It is Karuma Oruyo transmission line. It is Oruyo subs. It is Karuma Lira transmission lines that have been burst today. And I thank God. We are here celebrating because in the factory we have the power. We are now trying to evacuate and transmit it. But as we transmit it, we are making sure that the consumers are prepared.
Today, while commissioning the Oluyo substation, the Minister of Energy and Mineral Development, Ruth Nankabirwa Sentamu, revealed that the vandalism of the power line construction materials has been a contributing factor to the continued delay in connecting West Nile to the national grid. In the meantime, the business communities in Arua City, Koboko and Nebbi municipalities, the townships of Pakwach and Paida, are being encouraged to expand their businesses in preparedness for the arrival of reliable electricity in June 2026.
Your house. Some meters misbehave because too much power has entered. A fridge can blast because of too much power. So you must have a fridge guard.
The Oluyo substation will supply electricity to Lango subregion through the Oluyo to Lira 132 kV line, to the Acholi subregion through the Kole to Gulu through the 132 kV line, and West Nile subregions through the Karuma to Oluyo 400 kV transmission line.
Quite sure this power will really help my people in many areas. One, in terms of development, it will create industries, definitely, because people with industries, the investors will come and bring a lot of industries here since the power is now in existence.
West Nile has been waiting for this power from the time we ever existed. We have waited because we want to be part of the man economy, we want to be part of social economic transformation.
The addition of Oluyo substation has raised the prospects of a faster economic development throughout northern Uganda.
That in terms of industrialization, we are still lagging behind, and the West Nile connection has been crying for power, and I believe the entire region is going to be put on light, and transformation is going to yield very many.
This is what we're going to explain to our people. But we hope and pray that this time the deadline of June 2023 is not moved again. There's two substations in West Nile, Arua substation and the Nebbi substation, are at 86%. Completion rate.
However, the local leaders are being called upon to conduct community sensitization among the local populations to accept the project.
Primary beneficiaries of this project are the current and future electricity consumers in the project areas, Central, North, and West Nile regions. Furthermore, the project being commissioned today is expected to meet the current and future demands of electricity within Uganda and her neighbor.
The 400 double circuit Karuma to Kaunda line is among the 15 projects slated for commissioning soon, while the 600 megawatts Karuma hydropower is also expected to be commissioned later this year.
Other people have come in late and they are complaining why Africa is working with China and India. It is their shawli. They came in late. The Chinese were first. But my word, last word to you, is to always make sure that you do good work. Value for money. Quality of work. Please be careful. Produce good work. The opportunities are there. You are now facing tough competition.
The project is funded by the Exim Bank of China to the tune of $246.4 million.
Your substation is expected to be the nexus of power supply across northern Uganda. It will connect Lira, Gulu, and West Nile. I am Joseph Omagoro, reporting for the news in Oya District.